Hi, I'm Mary, and I'm 16. Tell me, do you like movies about the zombie apocalypse? Aren't you afraid of The Walking Dead? You're cool, but I'm afraid. What do you think? Can this really happen? And would we have to run and hide from the crowd of zombies? Write in the comments below. Meanwhile, I'll tell you my story about what I found at home and how it all ended. It started after my parents and I moved to another city and settled in a new house. It was an ordinary two-story townhouse with a green lawn and a backyard barbecue. I'm sure many of you have the exact same ones. But one day, when my parents weren't home, I found something secret in our house. I was going down the stairs to the first floor when one of the steps creaked strangely. Why did this particular step make sound? Of course, another time I would have just walked past. But at that moment, I was bored and decided to explore the strange step. I began to touch it and realized that it was not fixed and could move. There was an inconspicuous handle on the side. I pulled it, and part of the stairs opened like a door. Wow! Under the stairs was a small room hidden from prying eyes. I groped for the light switch. What I saw scared me at first. There were some creepy tools underneath. Pictures were hung on the wall, like from an anatomy textbook. And there was a suit in the corner. It was covered in spikes and chains. What was it? And what was it all for? When the fear gradually passed, I crawled into the lodge under the stairway and began to examine everything carefully. Up close, it didn't seem so scary anymore. The secret place was more like a zombie-themed fan's den. There were a lot of Walking Dead comics in the boxes. And I just loved the comics. So I got stuck in reading them until the evening when my parents came back. Since then, this became my personal space. I was hiding there from the world, enjoying the solitude in the comics. At one point, I even wished that a zombie apocalypse had actually happened, even though I didn't believe it. There was everything necessary for survival. A pile of canned food and pasta, a can of gasoline, and a brochure about the pharmaceutical company Allerbam, which was located nearby. But the more time I spent in the room under the stairs, the more I wondered who had built it. Who collected all these things here? I imagined a crazy man with shaggy hair and wild eyes. I laughed at how vividly I imagined the former owner of this lodge. But I was still curious, and I decided to find him. I got information from my parents about the previous residents of this house, and found out that they had a son, a guy my age named Theodore. Most likely, this was his secret hideout. I searched the internet and dug up the address of the house where Theodore's parents moved. It was in our city, but in another district. I found their house pretty quickly. It was almost the same as ours. I looked over the fence and saw a guy in the backyard. He was sitting on the lawn, reading a book. I called out to him and asked, "Hey, isn't your name Theodore by any chance?" The guy looked at me in surprise and went to the fence. "Yes, it's me, and who are you?" The guy was pretty good looking, with sad, intelligent eyes. He didn't look like the crazy zombie fan I'd imagined. I told Theodore that my name was Mary, and I lived in their old house. I just wanted to meet the former residents. The guy smiled and said it was very good of me. He introduced me to his parents, who were very nice people. We drank tea together and chatted, but I didn't say anything about the secret room under the stairs, just in case. From that time on, we began to schmooze with Theodore in a friendly manner. He was very smart and well-read. It was very interesting to talk to him. Moreover, we had much in common. For example, we loved comics and could spend hours discussing the adventures of superheroes. Once, during such a conversation, I asked, "Theo, aren't the zombie comics in the room under the stairs yours?" He thought to himself for a moment and said he didn't remember. It was strange to me. After all, I was sure it was Theodore who had set up the secret lodge. So one day, when my parents were not home, I invited him to visit me. I told him there was a surprise waiting for him and opened the door to the room underneath. Theo was so surprised, as if seeing the room for the first time. I turned on the light. When Theodore had examined everything that was there, he said, "Wow, this is so cool!" He took a look at everything. I still didn't understand why the guy didn't remember anything. Maybe he didn't set up this den after all. But my doubts quickly disappeared when Theo suddenly said, "I think I remember. These are my comics. I haven't read them for such a long time." So we started reading zombie stories together. It was so great that we didn't notice when my parents came home. Of course. They didn't find us in the shelter, and we sat under the stairs for hours and laughed softly. In general, we increasingly began to spend time in our shelter in case of a zombie apocalypse. Finally, Theodore recalled everything. How he collected all these things. How we spent time here. He even told me about the conspiracy theory he was investigating. It was about the pharmaceutical company Hollerbam, located in our city. Theo found out that they were doing some research there and were preparing to release a new drug that would turn everyone into zombies. I laughed and said he was just a dreamer. But Theodore answered seriously, "You don't believe me? No one believes me. But it's true!" I didn't snicker at him anymore. Theodore just had a fertile mind. He spent more and more time in the lodge under the stairs, drawing something, making something. Sometimes I would come home from school, and he was already in the secret room. He stayed over there, and it started to scare me a little. Theo became nervous and restless, and I decided to stop it and not bring him here again. But before I could, Theodore disappeared. I just looked under the stairs one day, and he wasn't there. Along with him, some of the items disappeared. I was uneasy about it. Not that I felt sorry for the missing junk, but why would Theodore want it? And I felt that something bad might happen, so I rather ran to the guy's house. Theo's mom opened the door and said he wasn't home. And for a long time, she was very concerned herself. But after I told her about the secret room and what Theodore and I had been doing lately, she was horrified. "What have you done?" His mother screamed. She started running around the house and making phone calls. "What's going on?" I asked, surprised. And then, the woman told me a terrible story about her son. It turned out that when they lived in that house, he found a storage room under the stairs and made it a den for himself there. The parents didn't mind. Theo always loved comics, and especially zombie themes, so he made a fan club there. At first, everything went well, but over time, he became obsessed with the idea of a zombie apocalypse. And when he finally went crazy, he took a can of gasoline and went to the building of the company Hollerbam to start a fire. He seriously believed that they would turn everyone into the Walking Dead. There, of course, he was stopped by the police and sent to a psychiatric clinic for treatment, where he spent 6 months. His parents had to change their house so that nothing else would remind him of the zombies. And then, I had realized what I had done. I refreshed Theodore's memories about what the doctors had tried to erase from his mind, and he went back to his old ways. It was urgent to save him. Theo's mom and I got in the car and drove to the pharmaceutical company. Of course, he was there and tried to do something stupid again. Now he was exactly what I had imagined him to be at the beginning. Disheveled, mad, wide-eyed. I was scared, but I shouted anyway. "Theo, stop! You're making a mistake!" But he answered grimly, "You don't understand. Soon they will release a new medicine, and everyone will turn into a zombie." Theo's mom tried to talk him out of it too, but he wasn't listening to anyone. I can't imagine how it would have ended if the police hadn't shown up and grabbed Theodore. He shouted to be released, but the police put him in a car and took him away. When it was all over, the guy's mom came up to me and said with tears, "I forbid you to approach my son. Do you hear? Otherwise, I'll sue you." She left, and I stood there for a long time, wondering what had happened. Of course, I wasn't going to get involved with this guy again after all I've learned. But how had I not recognized before that he was crazy? When I got home, I decided to get it over with and throw all the zombie stuff out of the lodge under the stairs. I might even sell it online to fans like Theo. Then, I accidentally saw a news item in the feed on my phone screen. The pharmaceutical company Hollerbam, after long research, finally released a new drug. What? I felt a little dizzy. No, of course, it's all nonsense. But what if Theodore was right? I don't believe in a zombie apocalypse, but I decided not to dismantle the secret room downstairs yet. And do you think Theo is healthy? And we're all crazy and don't know where our world is going. Share my story, because I don't know what to do.